the ACT Monologues. 70 Green Bottles by John Abel. Performed by Jason Kenyon. I don't really need it. It's just a helpful friend. The only friend that has been ever present and never lets me down. It used to be wine, but not really strong enough. I suppose it started when my wife ran off with my best friend, who was our lodger. Although he was out of work and a little thing like paying the rent seemed just an extra burden I was unwilling to put on him. Anyway, one Monday, on her 40th birthday, I had toodled round to her work at lunchtime to give her a huge bunch of roses and to take her lunch, only to find that she'd already left, or not been in at all, depending on which workmate you spoke to. Bloody civil servants, all thick as two short planks. So I just kept them until I went home that evening. I came home to an empty house. No wife, kids, furniture or friend. Just a Dear John letter, which was okay in a way, because my name is John. Apparently taking away my reason for living and going to work and even breathing was actually going to hurt her more than it did me. A great consolation. And it was her, not me, who was to blame. Duh. Well, obvious or what? And she was obviously so incredibly sorry, etc., etc., etc. Funny thing, though, no mention of my best mate, who had obviously, coincidentally, disappeared at the same time. Well, after alternately dissolving in tears and phoning her parents for about 18 hours, I resolved to go to work and tell no one, as it was obviously a mistake of some sort, and anyway, I was sure I could find out where she'd gone. At this point, I had a collection of 70 bottles of wine in the house. Nice of her to leave those. But hadn't even thought of drinking one. Through sheer brilliance and no sneakiness or luck whatsoever, I did indeed track her down and telephoned her the next evening. To be honest, it was not too fruitful to begin with, as I was crying too hard to hear what she said and sobbing so much, she could not, I found out later, understand a single word I said. Still, it was contact. And it continued. Eventually, we even understood what each other was saying and arranged for my first visit from the kids, which was great, if you count one adult and two children huddled on a sofa for 3 hours hugging and crying as great, that is. Still 70 bottles left. Well, I wasn't going to drink in front of them, was I? Things carried on very civilised. We even met for lunch once a week for a few months, until one day she announced that she was 2 months pregnant. I, being no fool, pointed out the impossibility of the announcement, as we had not made love for 4 months. Honestly, sometimes she was so dim. She then announced I was not the father. Didn't see that coming. Went home and cogitated and came to the conclusion, after drinking one or two bottles, that just maybe the marriage was possibly over. So rang her and told her I was divorcing her, which she took very well. I didn't. 67 bottles left. To cut a long story short, the divorce went through, though why I, as the aggrieved party, had to attend the traumatic hearing and she didn't seems a bit unfair to me. 61 bottles left. I and my wine had to move out of the family four-bedroomed home, as I could no longer afford it, and after 3 weeks in a ghastly guest house found a flat in the same place as when he had first left home 22 years earlier, which helped no end in my feeling perhaps that I'd wasted 20 years of my life. 52 bottles left, though I still think someone may have taken some without my knowing. Oh, did I mention that the ex gave birth to a baby boy during this time? 47 bottles left. Oh, and the good old best mate was the father. I didn't? Well, hardly seems to matter, really. 39 bottles left. Also, did I mention I lost a couple of jobs as well? No? Well, hardly seemed to matter, really. 26 bottles left. Oh, and I was diagnosed with diabetes as well. No? Well, hardly seems to matter, really. 17 bottles left. So then, apparently I missed an appointment at the diabetes clinic because I woke a little late, 3:34 p.m., with the last 17 wine bottles empty on the floor, and someone, I'm not quite sure who, decided I needed some assistance from the alcohol and drugs clinic, which strangely does not provide you with alcohol or drugs. And I was made to see the error of my ways, as empty calories from too many bottles of wine does not sit well with a diabetic system, and the alcohol content was doing little for the antidepressants I was taking. Did I mention those before? No? Well, hardly seems to matter, really. So, I resolved to be more sensible and changed to vodka. Less amount by volume, so less empty calories and less alcohol, surely. So there you have it. I am now fine, and the fact that my life crumbled 16 years, 11 months, 9 days, and 11 and a half hours ago hardly seems to matter now. We're fine, thanks. Just me and my pal.